Okay, well, welcome to this different episode. I'm trying to narrate this because obviously in the last episode my microphone went wrong. So here we go, let's go for it. So this is a little town in Serbia called, let me just get Google Maps up. This is called Veliko Gradiste. And it's very nice. So this is on my way towards the Romanian border. Yeah, I stopped for a little sandwich and a ketchup.
Just stopped at a town called, I can't remember what it is now, something. And just had a nice little baguette. Now we're going to head over to the Romanian border. The Danube is just down there, so we're going to head off down there and, we've got to wiggle on the Danube for a good 30 kilometres, which should be quite a nice ride. So anyway, I thought I'd show you around. Cafe Las Vegas. It's actually pretty nice.
So I saddled up and hit the road. So this is actually down on the Danube itself, and over in that side, those green luscious hills, is Romania. But there's a really nice ride coming up now. I think it's probably about 60 kilometers. There's not many bridge border crossings through here, but yeah, it's a great ride.
I just stumbled across this abandoned petrol station, and I thought it looked cool, so I just pulled over to take some pictures in the middle of nowhere in Serbia. Still sounds so weird.
And this is Garmin being Garmin and taking me into a very remote little village that I don't think I even had to go to, but anyway, here we are. I actually quite relished the opportunity because I do have a GS, I am a GS rider, and most of them never go off-road, and this is the limit of the off-road that they do. But anyway, back on the main road, and this is the I want to say coastal road, but it's not really. This just runs along the river between, that is the Danube on the left, between Romania and Serbia, and it's absolutely glorious. I'll get the name in the description of this road. This is an ominous site. So unfortunately, when I came, this whole road was being resurfaced, and it was really tricky to ride on. I don't know if you can see it here, but there's like these longitudinal ruts, and riding a bike in these ruts is very difficult. And the tunnels have got no lighting in either, so it was all a bit adventurous, let's say. Oh, and these are some little cheapy bull ram things. I don't know what they're called, but they've got big horns. But yeah, the roadworks was pretty taxing. And that went on for quite a while, but this now gets really good. So I've just crossed over one little section, and this is on the way down to the border. And this is such a beautiful stretch of road. As you can see, it's absolutely glorious. I mean, unfortunately, the weather was a bit crap today, but it's smooth, beautiful surface, and it just goes on, and it's very quiet, no one around. It was fantastic. Oh, watch out for rock falls as well. And not even just the big ones, like you'll often come around the corner and find little, like here actually, like little dobbles of doo-doo. Where are we now? There, and the road just keeps getting better. I mean, this is absolutely staggeringly beautiful, and I highly recommend, if you into bikes and touring, going down here, it is glorious.
Well, this road has everything you could possibly want for an adventure. So this side is Serbia, this side is Romania, and the road, this is the Danube, and the road that runs down here, I'm sure it's the same other side, it's just insane. And there's loads of rock falls and stuff like that, so it's you got to keep your wits about you, but it's amazing. It's absolutely amazing. So yeah, we're about half an hour, maybe less, away from the Romanian border, and yeah, it's just amazing here. And there's no one here. There's no one here. Look at those mountains over there. Probably won't focus. Look at that. But yeah, my bestie's done it all with me. So yeah, okay, we'll have a quick drink now and then get to the border, change some batteries over, and get into Romania, hopefully. Bye.
So approaching the border crossing now, there's not many bridges over this section of river, and I think this one is called, here, let me just pop up Google, is it Durdap? Durdap? The Iron Gates? I haven't done much research, of course, standard. But the Serbian border guy was really, really lovely, and yeah, very nice, and asked me if I'd enjoyed his country, and da da da. It was really friendly, very friendly. And now this, unfortunately, is the state of things in Romania. Suddenly, from very, very quiet roads to hugely busy roads and a lot of lorries. It's obviously still beautiful, as you can see here. But from feeling quite remote, these roads in Romania, there's not many, very, very few. I think there's only something like 90 kilometers of actual motorway in the whole of Romania. So most of the travel is done on these single lane, single carriageway roads. I tried overtaking some bits and bobs, but it was futile, pointless. So I just settled in. At this point, I was still waiting for my signal, my mobile phone signal to come in and book a hotel. And I was actually getting quite nervous, I think. This was very, very different feeling in Romania. I liked it, but it was definitely more edgy. But traveling around, you can see, it's just these lorries after lorry after lorry. So it was really slow progress. And I eventually stopped, managed to restart my phone, got some signal, and realized I was going in completely the wrong direction. So I had to turn around and go 2 hours back the other way to a hotel I just booked in the middle of nowhere. And it didn't seem that far away, kilometers-wise, but because the travel on the roads are so windy, it's so mountainous, it took forever. But anyway, this is a nice, well, is it a nice, it's a strange, it freaked me out a bit, this little town. This is called Pesiniska, I think, or something like that. Yeah, it's a very strange town. And anyway, and 2 minutes after that, you're in the mountains, and I did feel quite lonely and anxious out here because the roads just were, this is like a main road, and it was just, I don't know, it just felt very alien to what I'd been going through. But beautiful scenery, as you can see. And I think if you did this trip with a mate, this would be brilliant, but I was a little bit nervous and apprehensive. I didn't know if my hotel booking had gone through and all that stuff. Those little weird haystack things, they were everywhere. I don't know what they are. This was a bit of barrier that someone obviously disappeared off and never to return again. But yeah, a lot of it like this, mixed surface, it's damp, and yeah. But up the top of the mountain, this was really nice. This was a tiny little road. And I actually really enjoyed this, and it sort of cut through these really remote, well, not too remote, but these little villages, and the people were so lovely, and even just driving through, obviously there's a cow there, more little haystacky things, and all the time, anytime you saw kids, I think there's some coming up here, and they're just like, yeah, rev the bike, woohoo, and it's just like, it's lovely, it's really nice, and everyone in these villages, they seem to be a real tight community. I'm sure they don't have loads of money, and maybe I'm being a foolish Westerner here, but it just seems like a really nice place to live and a nice community, and there's like people out doing stuff, and there's churches, and look, kids on swings, and logs, and help people in a bar. It just seems like, for a small village, there's lots of people out, whereas you go around a small village in the UK, there's no one there. Loads of people helping shovel muck off a lorry. Anyway, then I got lost and couldn't find my hotel and stopped. And these local kids came up, and I visually showed them the hotel I needed to get to. And they were very kind and helped me out. And then now, this was such a nice little hotel, and I felt so relieved after a really long day. It's probably about 9:30. Now, and I'm like, yes, this looks like a really nice place, and it was fantastic, and it felt like a little sort of sanctuary, a haven, after feeling like I might have had to, I don't know, sleep in the woods somewhere. So yeah, it was lovely to get in and get a good night's sleep.
Morning. How is everyone?
Yeah, you're right.
Just woken up. I'm in my sanctuary, my hotel in Romania. It's actually a really nice hotel. If you're traveling through this area, this is a really nice, cozy sanctuary. Yeah, it's like finding something. I don't know, I felt yesterday really alone and scared that I was just going to end up, I don't know, sleeping in a tree away from bears. But then bears can climb trees. So I'll put the link in the description to this hotel. It's, yeah, it's really nice. It's traditional, but it's really comfortable. And yeah, the food's really good as well. So anyway, I think it's going to rain today. And I'm going to, I want to ride the Transfergasian today. But I don't know what the weather's going to be like. But anyway, I'll go there. It's about 4 hours away from here, I think. Maybe not that far, actually. And I'll go there and see. And then tonight, I don't know where I'm going to go. But maybe Brad's off. So I'll look for a hotel around there. And then if it, that's not too far from the transfer of the gas shim anyway. So if it's ruined today with the weather, I can always go back tomorrow. And yeah, I'm so glad I feel better. Yesterday was a real moment for me. I think I probably said it on the GoPros, but it felt like I've sort of pushed through an area that I pushed through the anxiety and just went for it. And I'm really proud of myself that I didn't go home the other day after all the issues and feeling like I desperately want to be at home. So, you know, the Transfergasian Brand Castle, that's kind of where I thought the end of this trip might be. But because if that's the case, then it's almost over in a day or two. So, which I'm not, I don't know if I'm quite ready for that. But then I can take a long route home and still enjoy that. So maybe that's what I'll do. Anyway, I'm going to go and put some pants on because I'm naked.
Hello.
And I'm going to go and have some breakfast and then look at a map. I spend my life looking at a map. And the other great thing about Romania is I can use my 4G data. That makes me feel much more in control of what's going on. Anyway.
Bye.
Right, well, it's just started. There's a bit of drizzle in the air, so I'm just going to have a little drink and hopefully it'll pass. But what I did, I just thought I'd give you a real quick little... If you do stay in this hotel, it is called... I'll put it up on the screen now. And they're very nice people. It's a nice little hotel. It's comfortable, clean, good food, and it's like a sanctuary in the middle of nowhere. And it was £45 for the night, inclusive of breakfast. And the rooms are really nice as well. So yeah, if you're out this way, stay. There must be a thing here somewhere. I know it's a name I can't pronounce very well. I don't know. I don't know what the name is. Anyway, right. Let's head to the Transfergasian. Nice.
So I'm obviously still oblivious that my microphone isn't working. But anyway, I set off. Look at this, lovely family scenes. Beautiful. Loved it. So I set off for the Transfergasian. This is actually the little village, the local village to that hotel, and it was really nice as well. It almost felt sort of almost weird Caribbean sort of influence, but anyway, and a drug dealer's Bentley there, but anyway. Then the rain came, and this was a sort of, I don't know what town this was, but I just thought I'd put it into this edit just to show you a bit of what the urban life looks like out there. And then the sun came out, and I'm fiddling with my sat-nav, and it doesn't work with the gloves. Cool 4x4. So this is kind of the start of the Transfergasian, and there's quite a lot of touristy things around here. And then before you know it, you're up in the mountains, and here's some bears. So this was my first time I saw some bears just chilling out and enjoying the scenery. And this is breathtaking. This really is. This is probably one of the nicer bits of the route. Absolutely stunning. I felt so sort of rugged, especially when you got wild bears and stuff hanging around. But it really did feel awesome riding up here. And then I got this weird little message. I don't know if you can see my phone pop up there. So this was like an emergency alert, and I'd never seen this before. We've just had that thing in the UK, but this is obviously installed in Romania. But that alert was telling me to watch out for the bears that I'd just already encountered. So not particularly useful. But anyway, there we go. I'm glad it warned me, at least after the bears. And yeah, cool little 4x4s on the left there, and run down walls and bridges, and it does feel like another world out here. I really enjoyed it. Again, I think I would have preferred to do this with a mate or a girlfriend or partner or something, because it was kind of something you wanted to share. But then it gets a little bit touristy. I think there's a dam on the other side of this little tunnel. Yeah, beautiful scenery. It's obviously a location for people to travel to and spend, like, I don't know, a little road trip, spend an afternoon doing stuff on the lake and riding motorbikes and stuff. So, but it is quite busy, and generally the whole road was pretty busy. Loads of dirt and stuff in the carriageway. The surface was very mixed. More bears, and then, I mean, these are wild animals, but they're just chilling out, and then people are just feeding them, basically. No one seems to really care that much. And I sped up this bit of footage just to give you a bit of, otherwise we'll be here forever, but this gives you a sort of an overview of the patched surface. It's not too bad here, actually. It gets worse further up the top. Another bear here, just hanging out. I don't know if they actually attack people. I think they're just hungry. They just want people's baguettes. Just tracking along the, inverted commas, the lake coast here. Another warning for the bear I just passed. It's funny watching this back, actually, because I forget all of this. You kind of forget when you're home, even these little bits. I don't know what I'm waffling about, but I'm probably talking crap. But yeah, and then we caught up with a Ferrari. Yeah. So this is now the climb up to the higher peak. Lots of switchbacks. Felt like quite alpine here, actually, but just with not particularly good surface. Very rugged, strange hotel-ish buildings. Again, pretty busy. And then I was not expecting this. So this, you go through a little tunnel at the top and you come out the other side. Obviously the weather makes this look even weirder, but it's a shitload of people and like a market of fruit and vegetables and other weird tat. It's certainly not like, do you remember that episode of Top Gear when they're like, look at this ribbon of tarmac in the middle of nowhere? I mean, it's proper busy up here. Proper busy. So that kind of ruined it for a bit. I mean, I know all tourist attractions get ruined with people. But it certainly doesn't feel like a spiritual event, let's put it that way. It's definitely a must-ride road if you're in Romania, absolutely. But maybe, I don't know, on a quieter... I think this might have been a weekend, I can't remember. A quieter day might be a bit better. So I stopped to try and take some pictures and stuff along with everyone else. But yeah, so that bit of road surface on the top was very... It wasn't nice to ride on a bike. It again had that sort of horizontal... the longitudinal rutting, so it just felt really awkward. But down on the bottom of the mountain, that was probably my favourite bit. So I'll wiggle through here and then, headed out and had an ice cream and headed up to Brasov, which is a medieval town. There's lots of history in there, but this was sort of a hotel on the outskirts. This is just something I booked from booking.com, whatever, and it was actually a really decent hotel. So I pulled in and had a nice meal, and that was it, really. So So yes, I hope you enjoyed as best as you can the visuals and narration from this video. I know it's not the same as live talking, but we've done the best we can. So I will now hand you back to myself, which is a very strange thing to say, on the morning of realization that my microphone wasn't working. All right, cheers guys. See you on the next one. Bye.
Right, so welcome to Brasov, in Romania, on the sort of middle to east side of Romania. I've just gone through all my footage and of Romania and some of Serbia, and the audio on the GoPro is screwed. So anyway, I'm just dealing with that utter disappointment today, after a morning of disappointment as well, really. I mean, this is a nice hotel and it's a nice place, but I think I'm just ready to go home and, or at least start winding my way back home. It's been an amazing trip, but I guess life isn't a movie, is it? And sometimes you think these things are going to solve all your problems and it's going to be like a happy ever after ending. And I just don't think life works like that. And I was maybe a bit naive to assume that this trip's going to solve all my problems and I'm going to be a happy, wonderful human forever after I've done this. That was a stupid thing to think, but it was kind of, I wanted to believe it. I'm not regretting the trip, obviously, but it's, with all the other personal issue, the other relationship and stuff issues, it just seems that this hasn't been the right time for this trip, really. But then, is there ever a right time, I suppose? So I don't really, you know, there's no climactic amazement here. This is the reality of life, I guess, and you never quite know how it's all going to work out. So I'm going to slowly start heading back west now. I don't know what I'm going to do about the GoPros and the cameras. I'm going to try and swap it over. I think I've got a spare mic adapter. I don't know what happened. Again, this is a nightmare. And stupidly, I should have fucking checked it yesterday, but I didn't. So, anyway. What's meant to be is meant to be. That's the only comfort I can try and muster, is that that stuff just wasn't meant to be said. And that's sometimes the only course of action you've got. As I stand in my pants. In a nice hotel, actually. This is really nice. Brasov is nice. It seems like it's quite wealthy compared to the rest of Romania. But anyway, I've got my computer station there, so I'm just trying to... I'm on the brink of having like some sort of collapse because it's so disappointing when camera equipment doesn't work. Anyway. I'm disappointed you guys didn't get to see it all, but anyway, c'est la vie. So I'm going to go to Bran Castle now, which is where Dracula lives. I don't think he does, but we're going to do that, and then I'm going to head back east, back west, and I might try and do the Transalpina today to make up for the loss of the Transfigation footage, but I don't know if the cameras are going to work. I mean, the camera works, it's just the audio. I don't know how, because you have to have this stupid, stupid dongle thing, which I'm just not going to be able to buy out here. They don't even make it anymore, because I've used GoPro 7s, but anyway. Enough technical shit. Sorry. And, yeah. Sorry if this is a miserable... I don't want it to be a miserable trip, I just want it to be reality, and I want it to be... This is a journey in itself, a mental journey, and I was naive and stupid to think that I could run away from my brain problems, because unfortunately my brain comes with me. Anyway. We've still got time, so let's float back and see what happens. Anyway, thank you for watching so far, and if the GoPros are unrecoverable, then this is the end of the line, I guess, so... Thank you for watching, and where's the happy ending? Sorry, you can have your money back. All right, you can't.